Hello Python programmers, this is AK. In this video, we are going to learn about how to create a COVID-19 news notifier using Python. I think this project is a very useful project in nowadays. If you are a Python beginner, then I suggest you to try this project. And this project is very helpful to boost your resume level. You can add this project in your resume and it will definitely attract the recruiter's attention. If you want more Python videos like this, then subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to get the instant updates from our channel. First of all, I divided this video into two parts. The first part is collecting the data about COVID-19 and the second part is using that data and make it as a daily desktop notification. So this is the overview about this video. So those who are watching this video, you need to install one package that is called as COVID-19 Pi. Okay. COVID-19 Pi is a small package that is very useful for collecting the up-to-date informations and data about the COVID-19 virus. By using this package, you will get all the data about the COVID-19 around the world. After installing this package, you need to import it in your IDE. So import COVID-19 Pi. And after that, you need to create the COVID-19 object. This is very important step. Using this step, we are going to collect all the data about the COVID-19 virus. So let's declare a variable called as COVID-19, and inside this variable, you need to write the package name that is COVID-19 Pi, and put the dot. After that, you need to write COVID-19. So this is the method to call this COVID-19 object. I hope you understand this. And after this step, you need to call the data source in the object that you created. So this step is also one of the importance in the program. Okay. So in this package, totally three different data sources are available. That is listed as JHU, CSBS, and NYT. These three represents the data sources. I will explain about these data sources. JHU represents Johns Hopkins Center, a worldwide data repository operated by the Johns Hopkins University Center for System Science and Engineering. This data source provides the worldwide data about the COVID-19. And the second one is CSBS. CSBS represents the Conference of State Bank Supervisors. It provides the US county data that comes from the Conference of State Bank Supervisors. And the last one is NYT. NYT represents the New York Times. The New York Times is releasing a series of data files with cumulative counts of coronavirus cases in the United States. So this is the explanation about the three data sources provided by this library. So this is the data sources that we have. If you want to use these data sources, then you need to call the data source in your object. So follow my instructions carefully. Inside the object, write data-source that is equal to JHU. Okay. Here I want the worldwide data. So only I mentioned JHU. If you want the US county data, then you need to call the rest of them. Okay. And the next step is you need to call a variable called latest. So the data set provides a lot of information about the COVID-19. But in this video, I only access the latest information about the COVID-19. If you want more updates about the COVID-19, then you need to see this video in our channel. This video will provide more information about this package. Inside the latest variable, write COVID-19, that is our object, and put the dot and write get latest. So this prints the latest news about the COVID-19 from the data source JHU. And this is the end of the first part of the coding. Let's start the second part. In the second part, you need to import the Pi notifier module. And from this module, we are going to use the notification function. So let's declare an object called as notification, and inside the object, you need to pass the parameters like title, description, and duration. Title represents the notification title and the description represents we need to call the variable in the description. And the duration represents how much time the notification is visible on the desktop. So let's give the title as Today COVID-19 News Updates. And in the description, we need to call the variable latest as a string format. Why I am calling the string format means the PyNotifier package only supports the string format data. str represents the string format. So only I called the variable as a string format. Okay. And the duration is 30 seconds. And finally, call the send object. This will send the COVID-19 news notification on your desktop. So we are in the end of the video, and this is the script that I want to share with you. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, then subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to get the instant notifications. Your support is very, very important to me. Kindly share our channel to your friends and colleagues, those who are interested in Python. Thanks for watching, and thank you.